abolition of slavery. The abolition of slavery was not very easy in France. It took nearly 100 to 150 years for them to abolish slavery. First of all, what is the need of a slave for the French people? Actually, the French people never needed for themselves any slaves. They used to buy the Negroes from the local chiefs. They used to go all along way to the Africa, and after reaching Africa, the famous ports like Nantes and Bordeaux, after reaching there, they used to consult the local chief leader and they used to buy the slaves from them by giving him some gifts, and later they used to pack them and bind their hands, buckle up their hands, and the conditions were very horrible and severe, and whoever is alive only will survive till the last. If anyone dies in the middle because of suffocation or because of any health issues, they will be thrown in the middle in the sea or in the ocean. How pathetic the situation is. And like this, the slaves or the Negroes of Africa are being deported to America to work in the fields, to give a great economic gain for the American landlords. So the people traveled from Europe to Africa, from Africa to America. So this triangular slave trade continued for more than a century, and many of the Africans branded as Negroes were taken away from their homelands to far off distant places and forced to work on very hardship situations. So some of the famous places where in America they used to take, the places are San Domingo, Martinique and Guadeloupe are some of the stations where they were being the home places for the Negroes who migrated from Africa and they were brought to United States of America. So finally, in 1794, after continuous thorough deliberations and serious discussions, the existing directory rule has given free slaves and they banned slave trade. But after 10 years, Napoleon, who declared himself as the monarch of France, reintroduced slavery in 1804. From 1804 till 1848, the slavery continued, and finally in 1848, the slavery was completely banned in France. So like this, slavery came to an end in France. Slavery means bringing the Negroes or the dark colored people from Africa. They were forced to work in the fields of the rich people in United States, and then they were not given any kind of payment for that. So they have to work at very less wage or no wage. This bondage of working is called as slavery without any rights. And this was encouraged by the African countries because the local chiefs used to sell off their own tribal people at very less cost. The European people used to buy them and then export them to the United States of America in very suffocating situations in the ships, which are filled with 300 to 400 people in a single room, and very hard time for them to spend on the boat. And later they used to go to the countries like Saint Domingo, Martinique, Guadeloupe, and the famous ports from where the slaves are being exported are Nantes and Bordeaux. Finally, in 1794, the directory rule has given free trade and no slaves further. They have given freedom for the slaves. But in 1804, Napoleon reintroduced the slavery concept because he wanted more number of slaves to justify his rule and to gain larger economic interest by making them to work in their fields. And later, in 1848, the slavery was completely banned. With this, abolition of slavery happened in France in 1848. Now, the revolutionary changes which have occurred in every day-to-day life of the French people, we shall have a brief synopsis of what are the major changes that have been brought and what is the differentiation before and after the revolution. When we take in the large lines, we can say that the changes which are brought in law after 1789, the changes were incorporated is the following of liberty and equality into practice by the law. So the law has been made to get liberty and equality into really practice in every day-to-day life of the people of France. That was a major achievement of the people after the 1789 revolt which happened during that time. And later, the freedom of speech, the natural rights, when the freedom of speech was actually being curbed when the king's rule was present, there was a strict censorship on the writings of the people, on the publications. So once they are approved by the royal family members only, that can be printed. But in actual terms here, when it was being placed under the natural rights, which are inalienable rights, where nobody can deny these rights to the people by the government. So people can express their views freely, openly against the government also. But now the difference after and before the revolution is, before the revolution everything should be in pleasing manner to the kings, not even a single word against the king. But afterwards we have newspapers, pamphlets, books, poems, poetries, songs flooding to the people of France from every corner, making the people to aware of the present happening situations so that they can understand it very clearly. It's not only confined to the educated section of people. It's not only associated with the educated section of people like reading books, reading newspapers, magazines, etc. It was also written in the form of folk songs, traditional songs, where even the uneducated people also can understand what is actually happening at that point of time. So it not only broke the barriers but also connected the larger group of the France. So there was a clear variation of life before and after the revolution. In 1804, the Napoleon took over the charge as a monarch of France, which brought many people saw Napoleon as a modernizer of Europe in the initial days. He brought many changes. He brought the uniform system of weighing system, weights and scales. He was actually considered as a modernizer for the Europe at that point of time. But later, when we observe, Napoleon army is invading every corner of Europe. He want to redraw the map of Europe, which again became problematic to all the other countries and including France. So again there was a division on the Napoleon's rule in the France itself. Some people started to favor the rule, some people started to question the actions of the Napoleon. So finally, after four battles were waged in 1815 at the Battle of Waterloo, Napoleon lost the battle. With this, the rule of Napoleon comes to an end. Napoleon, who raised from a status of a normal soldier in an army to a position of a military commander, from then taking over to be the dictator of France, his rose level inspired many people not only in France but across the world. His spirits of high intentions have always, even today, been an inspiring story for many millions of people across the centuries, from 18th century to the present 21st century. That's all we have in this lesson. In this lesson of French Revolution, we have covered all the aspects related to the reasons for the Bastille Palace incident, what are the conditions of the society at that point of time, what are the divisions in the society, what were the steps taken by the king which triggered the anger of the people, and later we also have seen the next consequences of revolution and the rule of Robespierre Maximilien, rightly known as Reign of Terror, and then the directory rule, and finally the rising up of military dictator to the power, Napoleon. With this, we come to the end of political structural changes in France. We also have focused our attention on the women's role and the abolition of slavery. So with this, we get the complete picture on France and the growth and the changes in the political structures of France. So I hope you all understood all the points clearly.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.